Sup, this is Dean Anthony TV. I'm here to do my recap of X-Men, the original series between 1992 to 1997.
The X-Men characters are Wolverine, aka Logan, Storm, Scott Summers, aka Cyclops, Beast, and Marie, aka Rogue, Morph, and also Gambit, and Beast.
Season 1, Night of the Sentinels, Part 1. The X-Men come to the aid of Jubilee when her forced parents turn her into a mutant registration, and she was attacked by the Sentinels. X-Men saved her by bringing her into the facility. There she learns a little about them when she decides to go back and check on the foster parents. She is captured. The X-Men discover that the group running the mutant registration program and intends to track and eliminate mutants, so they decide to enter a building and destroy all data. Episode 2. After destroying the files on the mutants, the X-Men escape Blackbird, but are stopped by Sentinels. During the fight with the Sentinels, Morph is killed. Beast is captured and imprisoned by the government. The X-Men manage to track down the Sentinel headquarters to free Jubilee. She decides to join Xavier's Academy. Episode 3. Enter Magneto. Magneto attempts to break Beast out of prison. The Beast will rather stand on trial. Sabretooth demands that Beast be set free and ends up destructive rage, prompting the guards to shoot and injure him. Cyclops aids Sabretooth and brings him into the mansion's infirmary, which does not sit well with Wolverine. Later, Magneto attacks a military missile facility. Episode 4, Daily Reunions. Professor X tries to heal Sabretooth against Wolverine's warnings, while Magneto attacks a chemical plant in order to attract the attention of Professor X. Episode 5, Captive Heart. Cyclops and Jean are captured by a group of human mutants called the Morlocks when they decide to go on a romantic date, much to Logan's hurt. Storm battles their leader, Callisto, for control of the underground mutant group. Episode 6, Wolverine abruptly leads the X-Men in the middle of night. Weary of Jean and Cyclops' relationship, he travels to the Arctic, where he encounters a vengeful Sabretooth. Wolverine stranded in the freezing waters following the fight and rescued by Intuit villagers. He befriends the Intuit and finds monetary peace in the village before Sabretooth shatters the illusion of peace. Meanwhile, Gambit proposes a journey to investigate the rumor that Genosha is a mutant-friendly island, much to the intense disapproval of Cyclops. Professor X sees potential and suggests and approves the mission. Storm, Gambit, Jubilee, and Mutant liking island paradise of Genosha. Episode 7. The X-Men discover the truth behind Genosha. As Gambit, Storm, Jubilee, and a host of mutants are made work as slaves in order to complete a dam which will power a Sentinel facility. Storm tries to escape but is recaptured and sent to a solitary confinement inside a small room, badly affecting her claustrophobia. Meanwhile, Gambit pretends to betray the mutants to gain the guards' trust by revealing Jubilee's escape attempt. He is not allowed to take another compound. Soon he escapes and helps a mysterious Cable. Gambit returns to break Jubilee and Storm out of the compound with the help of other X-Men to free all mutants in Genosha. Episode 8, The Unstoppable Juggernaut. When X-Men is trashed, the X-Men initially blame the Russian mutant Colossus before discovering the real culprit of the Juggernaut. Episode 10. Warren Worthington, aka Archangel, has been supporting Atlas development to find a cure for mutants. In quotes, queer. Cable attacks Archangel and learns that Dr. Adler has relocated to Mirror Island, Scotland. Meanwhile, X-Men is busy rebuilding the X-Mansion. Wolverine and Gabriel squabble. Rogue intervenes and Wolverine accuses him of having a soft spot for Gambit. Professor X did Garrus a meeting. It was the X-Men of Adler's experiment treatment to remove the mutant powers. Rogue decided to travel to Muir Island for the cure, despite Gambit's attempts to dissuade her. It's later revealed that the real Adler has been killed by Apocalypse. Since then, Mystique is posing as a fake Adler to help Apocalypse and slave mutants for search for the cure. Rogue eventually decides to selflessly keep her powers as soon as she could do more good with her abilities. Having failed to enslave Rogue, Mystique switches targets and plans to enslave Archangel next for Apocalypse. Episode 11, Days of Future Past, Part 1 and 2. So Bishop is sent back in time to stop a member of X-Men while assassinating an important political figure. Episode 12, Bishop, who believes Gambit to be the assassin, and the X-Men in Washington to stop the assassin of Senator Kelly. Gambit is ordered to stay with the Wolverine and Bishop as he sneaks off Washington and arrives to prevent a duplicate Gambit by assassinating Senator Kelly. It is revealed that duplicate Gambit is Mystique in disguise, who is attempting to frame Gambit and the other X-Men assassinated under orders from the Apocalypse. Bishop sees two Gambits fighting and attempt to kill both, only stopped by Rogue. Bishop returns to find the future unchanged. The final decision. X-Men and Magneto team up to stop Master Bolt from replacing Senator Kennedy's brain with a computer and engage in all-out battle against thousands of Sentinels. Kelly calls off an anti-mutant campaign and Beast is freed in prison. Season 2. The second season saw a parallel narrative between Professor and Magneto. Lost to Savage Land and interwoven throughout, many of the stories dealt with X-Men dealing with the Professor absence as increasing the backstory of X-Men, particularly Rogue and Wolverine. Scott and Jean are married while amidst Wolverine's fights, like Scott like romance in the Danger Room. Meanwhile, Miss Sinister was brainwashed Morph to lay traps to destroy the action one by one. Morph struggles with his split personality and evil side, shapeshifts into different X-Men, luring them to dangerous situations. For example, he tricks Gambit in trying to kiss a rogue policeman into shooting Storm and sends Jubilee into a mutant hate group alone. Changes the intensity of the Beast's Danger Room to high, sends Professor X to Antarctica, etc. Mr. Sinister and the boys kidnap Cyclops and Jean Grey while they're on a honeymoon. Meanwhile, the rest of the X-Men are in a mirror peril and bickering due to Morph's trickery. Eventually, Beast escapes the danger room. Gambit recovers from a kiss from Rogue, and Wolverine rescues Jubilee in the clutches of Friends Humanity terrorist group, which is complaining about a bubblegum he had to sniff in order to track it down. Morph disappears, disguised as Professor X, who is dedicated by Wolverine, who senses Professor X's scent is wrong. Gambit tricks Morph and reveals that himself and X-Men realize that Cyclops and Jean are in danger. They describe to the island to confront Mr. Sinister and the Nasty Boy. In Antarctica, the real Professor X meets Magneto and a pair of engulfed by avalanche. Episode 16, the Shadow King lures Storm home to Mount Kilimanjaro and possessing her young spirit son, Maginier, as Rogue and Storm travel to Africa to stop the Shadow King. Meanwhile, Wolverine finds Morph, but is unable to convince him to return. After ensuring a fight, Wolverine reluctantly accepts Morph in time for to heal his psychological damage. In Antarctica, Professor X and Magneto survive the avalanche, stumbles in mysterious rainlands called the Savage Land. Here, Professor X can walk again, but they're unable to use their mutant powers. Episode 17. Powerless, Magneto, and Professor X invade the dinosaur in Savage Land. Magneto says he's surprised by Professor X and rescues him as Professor X's life would be easier if Magneto died. Meanwhile, Omega Red is escalated by three corrupt Russian generals who want to reclaim and rule Kremlin Soviet Empire. Colossus goes to X-Men 4 to save his country and people. Jubilee decides to fly with Colossus to Russia and writes the note to X-Men, which is the refrigerator, which she pins to the refrigerator. Then she travels to Russia, and Colossus finds his hometown discovered by Omega Red. Back in the mansion, Wolverine finds a note, crushes it, travels to Russia as well. Wolverine, Colossus, Jubilee fight Omega Red, who proves to be near indestructible. Storm, Rogue, Gambit arrive in Russia as soon as after complaining about the person who crushed their late arrival. With the help of Colossus and the Darkstar, a mutant general who wants to protect her people, Storm freezes Omega Red in a block of ice, effectively bringing about the end to his tyranny. Colossus decides to stay behind Russia and to rebuild the country. Episode 18, Wolverine travels to meet a woman in his past named Havoc. However, it turns out that it'd be a trap catched by the Vindicator and Alpha team. In the flashback scenes, we learn that Wolverine's past recorded Dr. Cornelius' adamantium injections, Weapon X, getting nursed back by help by Heather, his recruitment to Alpha Fight, subsequent desertion to join X-Men. General Chastain sends Alpha Flight to recapture Wolverine to replicate Wolverine's adamantium claws and other test subjects. When this fails, General Chastain and Vindicator develop to remove Wolverine's skeleton from his body to study it properly. Heather is horrified by it immediately and resigns. The rest of the Alpha Flight revolt and help Wolverine escape. Wolverine confronts Vindicator and says that he will not mercy if they come looking for him again. Meanwhile, the rest of the X-Men are worried about Professor X's mysterious disappearance. Jean searches Professor X and Cerebro, but unable to find him, since Wolverine is in trouble. Episode 19, Wolverine travels to meet a woman from his, in the future, Cable realizes, episode 20, in the future, Cable realizes his world is disappearing due to Bishop time travel. In advance, Bishop had time travel from 2055 AD to stop a plague that apocalypse started. The plague was scientifically engineered by a terrorist group and increased anti-mutant sentiment, falsely accusing mutants of spreading the plague. And X-Men succeeded by destroying Apocalypse's laboratory, but killed by Apocalypse in the process. Cable from the future was horror to have the team up with Apocalypse in order to save his timeline. Episode 21, Cable comes to the present to stop Bishop and save his own future world. He arrives at the same time as Bishop and two other travelers battle to save their own respective future timelines. Cable finds killing Bishop and helping Apocalypse distasteful, but prepares to do whatever it takes to save his son and future from world from ending. Eventually, Cable comes from the brainwave delivery that let get infected by the virus. The woman's healing ability produced the antibodies needed to create a permanent cure, thwarting Apocalypse. Bishop returns to his timeline and discovers everything is still the same, although there is no longer a plague. Cable returns to his timeline, discovers the world is saved and his son is alive. Episode 22. Mystique's Rose Foster mother forces to revisit her own past. Due to Professor X's long disappearance, Miss Marvel suppressed conscious to break free, causing Rogue to receive haunting visions. Mystique's Rogue Hospital, where she believes that Miss Marvel is comatose body and remains in the past. She ran away from abusive mutant healing father found Mystique. Mystique raised her and one day sent her on a mission to attack Miss Marvel, resulting in Rogue absorbing her powers permanently. Unfortunately, when Rogue avoided Palace, she also observed her consciousness, leaving Miss Marvel in a coma and Rogue plagued with Miss Marvel's psyche. Rogue finds Professor X, who helps her suppress her visions along her memories. In the present day, Miss Marvel's consciousness begins to fight Rogue over the control of her body. Jean uses Cerebro to Rogue trap restrain. Jean uses Cerebro to Rogue trap and restrain Miss Marvel. Rogue is saddened regarding Miss Marvel's fate, but left with no choice. Mystique tries to convince Rogue to join her, but Rogue declares Mystique made her worse than a killer. She visits Miss Marvel's comatose body in the hospital, brings her files, tells the nurse Ms. Marvel's real name. As she leaves, Ms. Marvel's body shows the signs of life and gives a small smile. Episode 24, an alien mojo kidnaps the cast X-Men, except for Gambit and Jubilee, as his latest all-galaxy television hit. The X-Men is forced into acting out movie scenes for Mojo's entertainment. Eventually, they are set free by Spiral, meeting Mojo's mutant assistant, Longshot, Mojo's previous actor, and wants the limelight for that. Mila and Savage Land, Professor X find Magneto's Citadel. They also encounter Sauron, who appears to be a dangerous foe. Episode 25. Professor Xavier, Magneto, and Jean are captured by Mr. Sinister. The boys and mutates in Savage Land. It is also revealed that Mr. Sinister's shadow mastery leading to mutates. Mr. Sinister summons Sauron to use his mind control on Professor X, forcing him to send a message to Lord of Resurrection to the Savage Land. The remaining X-Men is aware that they walk into the trap, but travels to Savage Land anyway to rescue Jean and Professor. Episode 26. Upon touchdown to Savage Land, X-Men realize they no longer have their mutant powers due to Sinister's machines, and they're captured by the boys and the mutates. Wolverine alone evades capture by jumping off a cliff. He has to team up with Kaiser to rescue other people in the epic finale. Season 3, Episode 27. After the five-part Phoenix Saga episodes were... Wolverine's vengeful ex-girlfriend, a Japanese woman who named Yuriko, lures Wolverine into Morlock's tunnel. Wolverine is playing basketball with Gambit and Jubilee, and he receives a message that Yuriko is waiting for him in the tunnels. Gambit suspects it's a trap, but Wolverine says he could handle it himself. Jubilee, however, convinces Gambit to help Wolverine anyway to decide to fall Taylor behind him. Meanwhile, Yuriko blames Wolverine for the death of her father, the man responsible for Wolverine's antimantian injections, but then the lady just has to get revenge. During the resulting from battle, Gambit and Jubilee help Wolverine after it breaks free. Professor X realizes telepathic messages he's getting from a spaceship that Yuriko is after, and actually a warning which comes true when Wolverine opens up the ship to save Yuriko. Yuriko's alien discovery, a Shi'ar vessel, turns out to be a prison cell called Vasaris Gastrus prisoners, the spirit drinker, who absorbs the spirits of Jubilee, Rivers, and Morlocks. Yeto Yuriko, working together as Professor X and X-Men members, her arrived as backup, and Gambit was the spirit drinker for Regent Service. The Phoenix Saga, episodes 1 through 5. Episode 29 through 33. A missionary alien race from Shi'ar, Eric DeRoe, takes over the Eagle One space station. Compelled by mysterious visions, Professor X sends X-Men minus Rogue, who is out for a mission, and takes the places of astronaut crew, minus Storm and Jubilee, who remain with Xavier on Earth, which confrontation with Eric and mind control astronauts while entering Earth's atmosphere on space shuttle. Jean starts to become possessed by the all-powerful Phoenix Force, which sends her mental pleas for help. The space shuttle crashes in Jamaica Bay through other X-Men unscathed. Jean Grey's fate is unknown. When she flies into the air, displaying her powers in a new costume she never used before, proclaims herself as Phoenix and collapsing, suffering from commotion, memory loss, and vast new powers. Meanwhile, Professor Xavier pained psychic connection with the alien manifests and the astral possession of Xavier's dark side, who is hell-bent on destroying X-Men. X-Men banishing as to save Leandra. A runaway Shi'ar royal is a source of Xavier's painful psychic visions, from Juggernaut to the Black Tom Cassidy. Leandra reveals that he arrived on Earth seeking help to protecting Myocrara Crystal for a tyrannical brother, Deacon. And Jean Grey continues on in exhibit in inexplicable symptoms, fully embracing the Phoenix persona to come to the rescue of X-Men and Shi'ar Empire. Gladiator. Phoenix transports X-Men to Leandra's ships, including Swarmage Lee, where they're hitting the Mirror Crystal. A group of pirates called Star Jammers attack and steal Maya Crocker's from the X-Men. And Star leader Carissa used the crystal as much of bait, assassinate Deacon and convince the Cyclops to aid him to his plan, which going terribly. Deacon gets pulled in crystal and becomes the universe inside it. They forces both X-Men and Imperial Guard to desperately combat seemingly omnipotent dictator to no available on Earth is suffering in a multitude of eventual disasters that thanks to unstable Miracron Crystal. Can the return of Phoenix can help to turn the tide. Cyclops still in monitoring Phoenix death quits the X-Men and returns to orphanage to grow up and encounters his friend Sarah. Cyclops has a foul play of Z Kilgrave. Sarah's worthy benefactor as he comes to adopt children for an unknown purpose. Our angel has been obsessed with destroying Apocalypse when he blames the ruin in his life. Despite the absorption of Archangel's evil side, Rogue feels obligated to join Archangel in his dangerous quest and hoping to calm him down despite Gambit's protest. Meanwhile, X-Men travel to Apocalypse ship to find the ultimate way to stop immortal mutant madmen. Beast bonds with the ship's AI system, constructs a trap, but Archangel and thirst for vengeance destroy them all. Longshot reveals another world, tumbles in a world with no memory. He discovered by Jubilee, who takes a liking to him, and they both find a sense of run Mojo and his hunters. Former X-Men Bobby Iceman Drake is caught breaking the top-secret government installation. It's revealed that Iceman is one of the original five members, but due to the rebels' attitude towards Crystal Team and to run to return to a normal life, and his girlfriend Lorna Dane, who's mysteriously disappeared. Moved by his plight, Jubilee joins Iceman to return to installation to find clues. The X-Men follow suit and find themselves in a skirmish with a government-sponsored mutant called the X-Factor. Sauron kidnaps Storm to the Savage in order to feed from her mutant energy. Woman, Beast, Rogue, Jubilee go after in the Savage Land. The Dark Phoenix from 1 to 4. The Phoenix continues to inhabit Jean's body. Jean is beginning to lose control, and Phoenix begins embracing to take over. While the Inner Circle learn of Phoenix's power, they use Jason Wangarde to create a history of mind of a Jean/Phoenix. While they're protecting Dazzler, a mutant club singer, from abducted by the Inner Circle, Cyclops and X-Men caught in a dangerous affair. Professor X and Emma Force battle for the psychic control of Jean, and Inner Circle members quarrel on how they dispose of their criminals, the X-Men. Meanwhile, the Phoenix begins to grow in thirst for new evil sensations, turns on both of the Inner Circle and X-Men. The transformation of the Dark Phoenix complete, and she begins to her rampage. When X-Men confronts Phoenix and give up Jean's body, Dark Phoenix vows to destroy the team, defeating them as he forces X-Men to figure out a way to expel Phoenix Force from Jean's body without hurting her. The Shi'ar Court. Leandra reveals Dark Phoenix's vast destruction of the Vortis solar system, and the Kree's Dark Phoenix to transform and destroy and of a legend and must die. Professor X controls the trial, combat in custody of Jean/Dark Phoenix, who pits X-Men battle to the Shi'ar Empire Guard on the blue moon, the blue area of the moon, with both fate of Jean's entire being and entire universe in the balance. Cyclops discovered the Consort is his father. The Consort is the run for the Shi'ar authorities, who demand Cyclops to overtake him. Wolverine witnesses a crash of a spaceship carrying horrific humanoid insects, the colony which overwhelms him. Meanwhile, Rogue is a run-in Cody with her first boyfriend, who is unwillingly drained from the kiss and is developing her mutant powers. He offers her a chance to together again for the cost of demanding. Rogue begins the Cody in the headquarters of Professor X and Spider-Wing with him, and much to Gambit's annoyance, the rest of the X-Men proceed to search for Wolverine attacked by the colony. Wolverine, Cody, and Rogue are affected by colony spores and their transformation to insect-like creatures. But Wolverine managed to successfully reverse the transformation due to his advanced healing abilities. Wolverine lets Rogue absorb his powers to also heal herself. Rogue reveals that Cody delivery brought her to the continent to show her together as a Kali menace. Eventually, Professor X helps the X-Men escape telepathically, freeing the creature hosting the colony. Rogue tries to convince Cody to leave with her, but is too far gone and is part of the colony now. As the colony leaves, Rogue is confronted by Wolverine and Gambit. Season 4, 1995-1996. Juggernaut's life risk is a risk someone else uncovers the ruby of Psiotrope. Juggernaut's life risk of someone else uncovers the ruby of Psiotrope and claims the powers of Juggernaut himself. Omega Ray and Destruction from the former Soviet Union sworn in the Wolverine installed Mosby to sap the ocean to salvage a disabled toxic rogue nuclear submarine threatening to break up near Hawaii. His only condition is that Wolverine Storm goes down in insurance. Wary of the battle of the mutant supremacy, Magneto offers the transport to an orbiting astronaut named Astronaut M, where they peaceful and human-free lives. However, Fabian Cortez tricks Magneto into the escape pod and launches him into space. Magneto plummets heavily into Earth. Fabian Cortez excuses of Astronaut M, sending hundreds of missiles towards Earth. Meanwhile, Rogue goes into the help of the X-Men and tries to find the missing Gambit. Magneto frees himself and destroys both missiles and Astronaut M. Everyone escapes from the asteroid and is destroyed. All of them have returned, Gambit included. Meanwhile, Cortez is rescued from descending an asteroid Death Bird in an apocalypse. When Professor X suffers a slight concussion, his powerful psychic mind is suddenly open to manipulation. The Shadow King takes advantage of it and possession of Isaiah, leaving him lying trapped in the astral plane. The Morph rejoins X-Men. Terrorists attack a top-secret high weapons factory that interrupts his homecoming party. When Cyclops flies solo into tiny western desert, coming to see his old friend, his plane blasted out of the sky. Injured and unable to use his powers, he struggles into town, only to discover his friend is missing. And the town's a militant, mutant-only anti-group, the Children of the Shadow. Gambit, Wolverine, and Rogue take a trip to Germany. While Gambit and Rogue seem largely enjoyed each one's company and time together, Wolverine restless longs for some action. He tears the report of someone hiding in the local monastery. His arresting reveals it's a mutant Nightcrawler, whose devilish appearance in stark contrast and peaceful, deeply psychological nature. Later, in the townsfolk attacked him, burned monastery. The X-Men convinced townsfolk to not fear and they do not understand. Wolverine, too, learns something about the nature of faith. Trevor Fitzroy and Batman travel to the 1959 to kill Professor and Master Mold ordered them. They created an alternate present timeline where mutant Sentinels war destroyed everything. Basically, shared alternate present where Sentinels battle violently against the leader, Magneto, and his followers, and husband and wife, Wolverine and Storm. Bishop and the Shi'ar recruit Wolverine and Storm to help Fitzroy, but they failed. Failing to stop the assassination of Xavier, Bishop, Shi'ar, Storm, and Wolverine traveled to the future, and the future is this forge that time was interesting. They tested on Forge, and no idea what the time just are. They convince Forge that a few minutes that Eva dies and save them. Everything reverts to normal. Nightcrawler gets a mysterious message. He is from his birth mother, who never knew, in trouble. He turns to X-Men for assistance. Jubilee is baffled for a knife and wants his mother, who abandoned him. Nightcrawler admits that he's playing it, but his faith in God will help him overcome his rejection. The plot thickens with one of the team members reconciled. As at a mutant-human relations summit, Henry Peter Gritsch attacks and cripples Professor Xavier with an energy disruptor. The X-Men and Moriah McTarget try to save Xavier, but all seems lost. Leandra comes in and has a cure, but Professor Xavier must leave and go with her to the Shi'ar Empire to be cured. Meanwhile, Magneto makes his final preparation to take over the world with his mutant army, but an invasion from a Cyclops, Wolverine, Jean Grey infiltrate Genosha to tell Magneto that Xavier is dying. He halts assault on the humankind out of respect for his greatest army. equal, and only his friend. The final scene of the show depicts a lasting moment as all the X-Men and Magneto stand outside the X-Mansion and say goodbye to Xavier as he leaves with Leandra and her ship in the Sierra homeworld. Fox Kids. I actually woke up every Saturday morning to watch it exclusively for, you know, with the rest of the cartoons. The series was great and interested in seeing the new series, X-Men 97. Thank you.